Hello, children. Welcome back to QuadJacks Poker Radio. I'm just sitting down in this seat, most recently occupied by Zach, who decided to use Firefox, I believe. And so I'm a little unfamiliar with Firefox. I guess the whole thing is zoomed in very much. There we go. I'm zooming it out now. Wonderful. Now we can get started. Welcome to QuadJacks Poker Radio. Today is Friday, January the 20th. What was that, Zach? That's okay. It's quite all right. We started in a mad rush today. Today we don't really have, by the way, today, in just a few minutes, Vice President of the Bodog Network, Mr. Giannis, is it, Zach? Oddman. With one D, not Oddman. I think he's a very nice man. I've only spoken to him via email, though, and Skype. But he'll be joining us.
It's all there.
He's going to talk to us a bit about Bodog, Bovada, the anonymous tables, the poker, the recreational model of poker players that Bodog opts for. I can't wait to ask him about this Facebook and Zynga stuff, what he makes of that, because today we learned that Zynga's changed its mind about online gaming, or offering real money play. So now we have another contender in the race, and this is kind of surprising because last year, 2 months ago, the general manager of Zynga Poker said that they would not be pursuing. They had no plans for real money gaming. So what is up? That is actually what makes up the whole of our news today. This is what I chose to focus on. I wrote an extensive analysis of it. Long-ish analysis of the situation, because I feel it's important we look at it a certain way. So why don't I just do that? I will read to you guys. Here, let me sign into chat so that I can say hi to some of you. There we go. And so that I can also share the link, I decided to call it Zynga and Facebook Conspire to Confuse the Hell Out of the Poker Public. That is going what I'm going to be reading to you guys today. For QuadJacks News, for the day of Friday, January the 20th, 2012. Top story of the day, Zynga and Facebook conspire to confuse the hell out of the poker public. The world's largest poker site, Zynga Poker, remains the world's largest poker site, according to Zynga Poker general manager Lo Tony, who made this point 9 times in a single interview with Poker News in November of last year. Said Tony, quote, "After 4 years, we're the world's largest poker game. We have always been the world's largest poker game. We have more than 7 million people who play our games every day on Facebook. The beauty of Zynga Poker with our 7 million users daily is that even people looking for competitive games are going to be able to find that. As the world's largest poker game, I think our scale is so large that it takes a lot to be able to tip the scale for us. We were the world's largest poker game before those actions were taken by the DOJ, and we remain the world's largest poker game after those actions. We're really excited about the IFP, the Nations Cup, because our main focus is on our 7 million people that play our game every day. IFP said, well, you have 30 million people that play your game every month. That's almost the size of a country. Why don't we have a digital country? So there you have it. Zynga Poker is a digital country. Tony also said that, quote, we have no interest in going after the real money space. It is reported today that a Zynga spokesperson, who may or may not be Tony himself, has said that the company has reversed its position on the prospects of offering real money play. On the issue of being the world's largest poker site, however, the company remains firmly unapologetic. Reads today's statement, quote, Zynga Poker is the world's largest online poker game. with more than 7 million people playing every day and over 30 million each month. We know from listening to our players that there is an interest in the real money gambling market. We're in active conversations with potential partners to better understand and explore this new opportunity. Of additional interest is a comment made by an unidentified Facebook spokesperson in today's report. Quote, "We don't have any plans to get into real money gambling." That's Facebook speaking. If true, then this would be a startling refutation of a widely publicized story from November of last year, released only a few days after Mr. Tony's declarations, that Facebook in the UK was already making plans to license online gambling operators for the purpose of allowing real money games on its server, possibly as soon as the first quarter of 2012. In summary, in November of 2012, Zynga Poker was reportedly uninterested in real money gaming while Facebook was deep in its development. Today, we learn that it is actually Zynga that wants to do real money gaming while Facebook will have no part of it. Facebook will probably change its mind about this in 2 months because it is the world's largest social network with over 800 million active users. So there you have it. Where is IGT in Double Down in all of this? The president of IGT reportedly did a spit take upon learning of today's news. I can't put my finger on it, or my hand on it, or whatever the expression is. But let's keep everything into the proper context. Let's not forget the news that I was probably reading, much like I'm doing now, a couple of months ago. Which was that, as many of you probably remember, you know, Lo Tony, the general manager of the world's poker site, online poker site, explicitly declaring that the company had no interest. Did the company change its mind? Yes, and there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, the company would be stupid. This is not politics. You know, I don't think you can fault Zynga for flip-flopping on the issue of online gaming. If they thought about it and they're like, well, you know what? Maybe Mr. Tony should eat his words. Then, good for them. They're being flexible, and they recognize a good opportunity when they see it. But where's Facebook in all of this? Why does that article in All Things SD quote a Facebook representative saying that there is no interest in offering real money gaming? Which is funny because no Facebook official representative, or no Facebook representative ever officially came out and said back in November or since then, I think, yes, we are indeed making plans to offer real money gaming in the UK. But it was reported by Gaming Review, and it seemed very reliable, very dependable. Those guys don't just print crap. So it seemed to make sense. And today, I think we have, do we have or do we not have the first official response by Facebook on that story or on that report? They're saying there are no plans. Maybe they meant in the whole world. Maybe they meant in America. I don't know. I don't think so. I mean, Facebook is very global. Facebook, I don't think Facebook is recognized as an American brand with like a presence in the rest of the world. No, it's a very international brand, I believe. So I don't know. We'll have to ask those EGR guys what they make of this. I'd be very curious to hear their take on all of this. But that's essentially it. We'll keep this story in mind as things progress. Let us not lose sight of everything that has come before us. And that concludes today's news point for QuadJacks. Right now we are going to take a break and come back and speak live with Jonas Oddman, the vice president of the Bodoc Network, on a variety of issues, including this. I'd love to ask Mr. Oddman if he what he makes of this. Maybe Bodoc wants to get into Facebook gaming. I don't know, but his is would be an opinion in which I would be interested. We'll be right back.